shit is about to pop off.
Woo!
Party! It's my birthday!
It's my 40th birthday party. I loved that episode so much.
Are they playing from the approved playlist in the main room? Because my thing was all bangers all the time.
To me, it was like the consummation of everything that I want to do on this show, that I get to do on this show.
Oh my God, this feels disgustingly Kendall.
Once we knew that Kendall was gonna turn 40, the party has that quality, right? Of something that's been thought about too much.
Congratulations. You've just been born into the world of Kendall Roy.
Oh, okay. So I'm inserting myself into my mom's vagina now? Is that what's happening?
Cold and inhospitable. Seems to check out.
That birthday party was an extraordinary set.
Incredible.
It was certainly one of my favorites to shoot because of the production design and the art direction.
Just seeing the page and going, how are they going to pull this off? And we had to shoot in various locations.
To think that Kendall has made people build these sets for his party. You know, in the compliments tunnel to hire actors to yell at you from bushes.
You're so full of grace.
What's that?
I think he said you're full of grace.
That's a weird thing to say. Being sarcastic?
And just like the preposterousness involved.
It's nothing but can we get Connor to lose his coat?
I had a badly torn rotator cuff. I needed to get it fixed. So they wrote it into the episode.
So Connor as well.
Kendall, it's like anything that messes with his vibe, just get rid of it.
The whole thing is just bizarre and sad.
Go on, tell us who's here.
Who isn't?
Your dad?
Your mom.
Your wife and kids.
Roman, going into that party with a mission of getting to Madsen and feeling pretty confident that if I can just get in the room with him and talk to him, that I can land the deal.
Well, I guess I do have one question, though. When will your father die?
Roman, he's got a capacity to cut to the quick.
Well, obviously, hugely looking forward to my father dying, but there's another shape to this.
That can be its own kind of strength.
Why don't we just, like, take a big old piss on our app? He can read people really well, and I think he's just good at that. It's that bullshitting kind of thing. All Madsen did is agree to a meeting, but going into that feeling really confident that we just built something really cool there, and I think I've solidified my position with Dad that I'm clearly the guy. Look at what I can do. I actually got something from Dad. We hope you like it.
Even very delightful moments in life can fade pretty quickly. The offer to buy out Kendall, it's a powerful signifier, and that's what Shiv sees as well.
What is it?
It's not, it's a little move to ease him out of the holding company.
You and Dad. Whole season up until this point, it's just been stacks on Shiv, in her mind at least.
You've taken some lumps.
I'm sorry, just historically, who owns the fucking company has been of some interest.
Dad and I handled it.
I handled it?
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, that's cute. Yeah, I love that. It's great.
We found the title late, which was from Bernstein Bears' book, Too Much Birthday.
It just feels like an asshole's birthday party. And my thing from the very first meeting was that it shouldn't feel like an asshole's birthday party.
It brought together a few feelings about the shape of the episode.
And went from the character being great to really hitting rock bottom.
Did you come here to see me at all?
In terms of the emotional event of the episode, the party was always meant to be the worst birthday ever.
Good night!
Hey! Birthdays are often a time for looking how your life's gone and where you're at, and that really is too much birthday for Kendall.